Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at the synthesis of ethers from the combination of an alkene and an alcohol, and this is an acid-catalyzed reaction. So here we have an alkene and an alcohol. The alkene has pi electrons, and so those are going to be more readily available. They're above and below the sigma framework of the molecule, and they're very susceptible to acid. So the first thing that's going to happen is our pi bond is going to grab a proton. That's going to protonate our alkene. Now the pi bond stretches across two carbon atoms, and so you're going to have one carbon that gains a proton and the other one is going to gain a positive charge. You're always going to see the formation of the carbocation that is the most stable, so the most substituted carbocation. So the proton will go on the terminal carbon and the carbocation will form at that tertiary carbon because that's the most stable. Now this is our electrophile that we've just formed. And so now the nucleophile, which is our alcohol, can come in and attack. So a lone pair of electrons on this oxygen is going to come in and attack our electrophile. And this uses reversible arrows. This is like an SN1 type reaction, this step, because you have capture of a electrophile, a carbocation, by a nucleophile. And so that would give me this molecule. So I'm almost done. What I just need to do now is deprotonate. Now I have an excess of the alcohol because the alcohol is going to both act as a base and a nucleophile in this reaction. And so another equivalent of alcohol is going to come in and deprotonate to give my final product. And this is just a acid-base reaction here, the transfer of a proton between a weak acid and a weak base. And so I'm going to draw equilibrium arrows there as well. And here's my final product. By convention for organic chemistry, we draw the neutral organic product, generally speaking. In practice, for a reaction like this, we would probably put in a weak base at the end of our workup, like in the separatory funnel, and neutralize everything. But we have excess of that alcohol that can deprotonate, giving us our final product. So this is the synthesis of ethers from an alkene and an alcohol. One of the advantages of this method is that you don't get a mixture of products. The alkene is always going to serve as your electrophile in this type of reaction, and the alcohol is always going to serve as your nucleophile in this type of reaction. If you combine two alcohols, for example, you end up with a mixture of products. So this is an advantage in that you don't have to separate similar products from one another, and you can predict in many cases just the one product that's going to be formed. So if you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends, and I'll see you next time.